for a shadow box, the bear shadow box. So when you get your kit, you will have two pieces that fit together for your stand that you can paint as well. Plus, you will have 7 individual layers. They will come strand wrapped all together, so you know the order that they go into. Or you just can mark on the back if you want with a number. So I'm going to show you how to do them with some inspiration of how to paint them. Basically, it's you paint every layer, you glue it together, you put it on the stand. Thanks, Avery, for telling me it's on the right page. So we're going to start with the back, and then we're going to move forward. So my stand, my shadow box comes like this, so I'm just going to flip it over and take the back piece. First, I'm going to do this kind of a lighter look, because what's going to pop through here is the northern lights. So this is the next, it's upside down. This is the next shadow piece that goes over top. So I want to paint this background color, the color that's going to pop through for the northern lights. So I'm going to paint it a light teal. It comes with all the paint. So I'm going to mix it on here, and I'm going to put on quite a bit of teal to do the whole back. And I'm going to paint my background. Now, knowing not much is going to go down in here, it's mostly all up in here. So I want to make sure that I put it on extra nice and thick where it's going to peek through. Not painting the edges. You can paint the edges if you want. I would suggest after it's all glued, you could do that, so it's all kind of the same consistency and it would be easiest. But I'm going to leave it all black, just the burnt color. So that's going to be the background of the northern lights. So I'll show you. Hey, I think so too. Okay, so I'm going to take that off so that it can dry. And then this one is going to be the background for the trees. So this next one is actually going to be the sky. So I want to do it dark blue, maybe a tiny bit of black up at the top. So I'm just going to wash my brush off. But this kind of gives it like the background, so I want it to be quite dark, so everything else pops. So I just dipped in black there, so I have half and half, and I'm just mixing it right on here. So it's a really dark navy, I guess. And a little bit of black. And I think it's okay if you have some parts like this is darker than over here, because maybe this is like where the sun went down or something like that, and this is more like a bit darker. Maybe the stars would come out or something like that. I think it just adds depth. Blue for down here. Now I'm just going to, because I'm doing this a bit quick, I'm just going to go in and make sure that I have all these tiny little pieces, as you can see, like from the forest. I want to make sure that I don't lift it up and there's like some brown wood parts. Again. So now I have, I mean, wait till everything's dry before you do this, but do what I say, not what I do. So you have your northern lights popping through. Oh, I have control of my hands. Hold on 2 seconds. And my next one's going to be my trees. You kind of see like how each layer kind of covers up a bit more and some starts to pop through. Just need to let that dry. Sorry, I have to wipe my hands again. I have glue all over the place here. Something is off with my mic, okay? I'm sorry, I'll talk a little bit louder. Is that better, Amy? She said anything, but I'm sorry if my mic is off. I'll try and talk super loud. Okay, so for these trees, I'm going to do a really almost dark black, almost like a silhouette. So I'm going to do mostly black and a tiny bit of light blue for my trees. It's mostly just the shadow. Better? Okay, good. Okay, I was talking too soft. I'm so sorry. So this is a really, really dark, I don't even, you wouldn't call it navy blue. What would you, midnight blue, I guess? Is there a midnight blue? I don't know. It almost looks like a little graphite, kind of like really dark bluey gray. I'll hold it up a little bit. This piece is quite delicate, so oops. Ah, I didn't flip it over. Oh no. Sorry. I'm so sorry. I apologize. I'm doing this backwards and upside down, and I didn't flip it over. I painted the wrong side. Okay, so how you know it's the wrong side? Because I took it from this pile that's over here and went like this. I didn't flip it. This scoring like this means it's the wrong, that's backwards. This is the right size. So do you see how it's more like just a shadowy effect? It's not as dark here. I'm so sorry, my apologies. That's it's my fault. That's what I get for trying to, do everything upside down. Okay, right side again. Let's try again. So sorry. But this is how we learn. At least you know if you do that, you can do this. Just wipe off the paint and go again. Keep mixing my dark blue with my black. Like I was saying, this part is super delicate. So just be careful how you hold it and how you move it around, just because it is so thin. Now I'm just going back over top of it. You probably want to do two coats, but I just want to make sure I have all the little pieces to show you. And then I'm washing out my brush. Okay, so again, you're not going to do this until everything is dry. But just to give you an idea of how it's coming along. So we have our background. Then we have our northern, oops, upside down again, northern lights. Then we have our tree. So I notice when I put these on that this is quite nice, the difference between here, but this is still a bit, it's matching a little bit too much up here. So I'm going to go back and actually make this even darker, just so there's a little bit more contrast. I hope that's okay. So now you have to watch this 3 times me paint this thing. Sorry. I could have also went back and made the sky lighter. As long as they're not glued, you can go back and repaint as many times as you want. Okay, so let's see now. Be very careful with paint. I put this over top there. I'm happier with that. I feel like it looks a little bit, just pops a little bit more. Okay. All these pieces dry, especially this one because it's been painted like a million times. And then I'm going to go over here again. Sorry, I have to wipe my hands because I keep touching everything. So now we're going on to the trees. And the next piece that goes over top of this is the bear. So this is kind of the last landscape one. So I'm going to make this one a little bit lighter, just so the trees kind of pop through, and I'll show you what I mean here. This one kind of goes over top, and some of these elements pop out. So I'm going to make it a little bit lighter. I'm going to make it kind of like more this blue and this green color. I'm just going to mix those together a little bit. And if you don't want to do a solid color, if you kind of feel like you want to do, I don't know, some dry brush strokes into it just to kind of add more texture, absolutely, you totally can. And in no way do you have to do it the colors I'm doing it. You can do whatever you would like. Okay, I'm just going to make sure I've gone over every piece. Oh my gosh. Again, these are the pieces popping through like that. Okay, and then now I have my bear. So I guess you can do your bear kind of any way you want, any type of bear that you want. I'm going to do mine white because I think, I don't know, it really stands out, and maybe it's a polar bear. I'm not quite sure how it'll look, if it'll look a bit funny because everything else is so dark, but I think it'll look okay. So I'm just wiping off on my brush. I'm just using a rake here to get it all out because I am doing white. With white, you're probably for sure going to have 2, if not 3 coats because you are doing a light color over top of dark. Plus, you're going over top of smoke or burnt lines. I'm going to do 1 coat here, but I would definitely like dry, come back, do another coat. Because as you can see, compared to a lot of the other paint colors, you can really see my lines in there, and it just doesn't look as nice and crisp. And I think with the white, you really want it to look nice and crisp. little corners. There. Super delicate with that one. And these ones are gonna have to be super, super delicate one. This is the last one, it's just the frame. I'll probably do that one black. This one is just like the land that the polar bear is walking on, and I'm going to try and kind of match it, make it dark as well, match it kind of to the dark trees that I did. So mostly black, little bit of blue. Too blue. Perfect. They get quicker. While they go. Oh, maybe I'll do this one. Maybe I should do this one brown for the border. And then maybe what I might do once they're all glued together is maybe I'll do the outside edging brown for my border. So the glue that we use is Mod Podge, and it dries pretty quickly, and it dries clear, so that if you have any of it sticking out, it'll just dry clear, but there'll be a little bit of a sheen to it. So when you're gluing these, this one's going to be the hardest one to glue because you have a really small surface, and you have to. There's an applicator, just a makeup brush, and you have to put it all the way around. Obviously, the bigger ones you're going to have some more contact that you can use to glue it, but this one's going to be the trickiest for sure. So you want to make sure that you're going all the way around. Okay, I will clear some of this paint out of the way so I don't have it spill. I'm not going to glue it only because everything is still wet, and if you glue it with wet paint, that's just a disaster. If they were all dry, you'd want to start with the back first. Putting that down. Then you're going to put your northern lights. This is dry. You're going to put glue in here, all in here, so that it's pretty sturdy and stays together. Okay, I have to be, forgive me here again, I'm working backwards. Again, these are pretty wet. And then the lab, again, you want to put glue here, tons of glue here, and then just kind of pull it lightly and brush with the applicator around. And then here is the last frame. Ta-da! Sorry, again, it's wet and it's not totally lined up because it's upside down here, but it's pretty close. So when it's all dry, all set, you want to pick it up and make sure no pieces are loose, and then you can paint your stand, put it together, and basically it just sits right in here. Just kind of mostly, it touches the bottom, it just kind of leans back. And displays your beautiful artwork. So I can't wait to see all the different colors that you picked, and I can't wait to see how they come together. And hopefully, you had so much fun and it was kind of relaxing and got your mind off things. Hopefully, you're having a great day, And thank you for watching. Happy crafting!